Hello, today I want to talk about the website speed up. First thing, what you can do on any website at all, it is reduce the website page size. And how you can do that? You already probably guessed it. Everyone can do it by the reducing image. So image compression, today I want to talk about that. By the way, my name is Airidas Kirstukas. Now the question is, why you should compress the image? First thing, you wanted that your website would be more searchable, more visible, more knowable. And if you want to achieve that, you need to increase the speed. And if the page is the smaller size, automatically the speed gonna be increased. So that's the first reason. Second one is the of the images protection. Hopefully you use your own images. Might be some of them, might be not. It depends. But if you have some right for the, some images, by the reducing size of the images, you're making so hard for other people to copy your image and to reuse it for their own. We still can do it probably. But anyway, you doing something for the protecting that. How you can do it now? Next step. And it's so easy. No one can have an excuse, don't do it. If you can see, you can pop in a Google image compressor, and then it's lot of all those kind of websites offering this kind of service. If you're gonna go, I picked like Tiny PNG because that was recommended as well from other people. That's not only my opinion, it is. And I as well has been recommended Compressor.io. But you can see it's so many. Just try, play. And if you're using WordPress, we have as well plugins. Even this one, TinyPNG, we have the WordPress plugins. You can install it, you can use it straight away. But from my perspective, the less plugins you're using, the better speed of the WordPress website you as well gonna have it. So it takes a bit longer to develop the website, but after you've done it, just delete that plugin then and don't leave it, because everything taking space. The longer website gonna load, the less customers you gonna get. We're just gonna have a look on those two. I just gonna go enter and free stock images gonna search, and let's go to Unsplash. It's a lot of the images. I gonna pick some colorful. Let's pick paint, and I like this image. I gonna download. Before you even downloading, you can see straight away is 1.7 megabyte. That's quite a lot. If you're using, let's say, 20 images on the website, it's over 20 megabytes. So it's a lot. If I gonna do cancel, I just gonna shut this one. You have the little arrow here, and then you don't need original size, probably this one. You don't need even large size for the website. Probably it's enough medium or even small if you just kind of small, kind of the texture, somewhere quiet. But I'm gonna pick that for this kind of tutorial medium. And you see 897 kilobyte. I just gonna save it file. Okay, I save it the file. I'm gonna go now to the desktop, download the file, as you can see. And if I'm gonna hover on the file, you can see and preview it's 896 kilobytes. We're going to back to the other browser, and I'm gonna drop the image here. I'm gonna pick this one and I'm gonna compress it. And as you see, finished. We've saved 52%. Press on the download and save the file. Let's go in preview. I open this file. That's actually after compressed, and this is original. As you can see, I personally can't see any difference. So it's both images is perfectly fine for me. I gonna close it then. So as you can see, we saved 52%, and our image size became half of the size as originally was. I wanna say thank you for watching this, and I would love to hear what you think about the content. Please drop the line below in the comments, and don't forget to like, subscribe, and put the notification bell. Thank you. And bye-bye, to the next time.